time to start again. We're 10 minutes behind schedule, but that's okay. We'll do that. It's my turn to speak. We had two external people to tell you about the funder perspective from the European Commission and an enthusiastic scientist on open science. Now we have those views in our heads, and now it's time for us, for open air, to tell you how we can help you, and afterwards ask you how we can help you even further and support you. So let me tell you something about open air and Horizon 2020. The context is that more and more funders in this world ask beneficiaries to stipulate open access mandates or open access regulations, and that people have to be supported for that, and that you have to link publications and research output and things like that. You have to link it to your funding source. And how do you do that, and how can we help you in that? Because you have the mandates, but you need support. And just one slide. We talked about open access in Horizon 2020. Caroline explained it all extensively. But this is the basis of how open air started to support the European Commission's policy. So that is what open air is doing to start with. It's a support infrastructure for the European Commission's open science, let's call open science policy at the moment. But more and more funders get interested in such an infrastructure to follow what's happening and to get the publications with connected funding details out there. So it is a participatory network throughout Europe based on repository network. So a big technical infrastructure. It supports the discovery and sharing of research results in open access and EC-funded research results. And you can connect them to data, publications connect to data, to funding details, related publication, of course affiliation and things like that, which is crucial for such an infrastructure. So this is how open air supports you. Now we have several stakeholders, and of course, first of all, you have the researchers that we want to help, and project coordinators who are in between researcher and a research administrator, because they have a lot of administrative work to do, project coordinator. So these are some of the stakeholders that we want to support. Of course, the data providers we want to support, because if you're in your own institution, you have a repository, and we want to make it open air compliant, we can help you with that, and it makes it easier for researchers to put information in that repository, and automatically it's harvested into open air. So the more seamless connection we can make, the better it is, of course. And also the funders are a good stakeholder. We want to initiate more contacts with funders, because what we have set up in the first place for the European Commission is interesting for every funder of research, of course. So open air is an open access infrastructure for research in Europe. That is what we are, and that is how we can support you. It is a key service now. It's no longer only a pilot, but with supporting open science in Horizon 2020, we support you better and better. Who are we? As said, an infrastructure which is operational, of course, 24/7, with 50 partners. So that's a lot of people involved. There are open access experts, there are more technical people responsible for the infrastructure. We have legal experts, because you know very well that there are lots of legal aspects to this, and data communities. Since Open Air Plus, more data repositories are joining us, and we have several communities, data communities in the Open Air project, to learn how we can better support and integrate repositories into their infrastructure. There are 33 countries involved in open air. 33 countries, you see all the names here, most of them from the European Union, but a few connected countries, associated countries, like Turkey, Serbia, Norway and Iceland. So it's beyond the European Union that we work, and Switzerland should have the same color as others. That is the human network. This human network is important for everyone here in the room. We have national open access desks in all of these countries. These are the people you can contact with questions on Horizon 2020 policies, on our support that we give, how can we help you, ask us lots of questions, because in that way we can support you even better, make better fact sheets, better guides, better things you can use. The other part is the technical infrastructure, of course, and I said this is based on repositories. Repositories with data, repositories with research information, repositories with publications, open access journals, we have contact with them, and we gather the information. Not only gather it, but make it better, enrich it, so clean, deduplicate, infer and validate, connect the information in several repositories. For example, if you have two records in different repositories, they can enrich each other. And this makes service even better. And we mix it all into one big CRIS system, that's open air. We add the Zenodo to this whole environment. Zenodo is a repository for those who don't have access to a subject or institutional repository themselves. They can use Zenodo for this purpose. And then there's a lot of services coming out. Services for several stakeholders, lots of APIs you can use for project coordinators. You can embed the project list, for example, in your own website. Reporting is made easier. And then we add still more information. So there is a lot of information in that system that several stakeholders can use. It's not only about gathering the information and just make it an administrative burden. It's absolutely open air's purpose to give you services, services that you can use and that are useful to you. Repository managers are an important key in this whole network. So contact repository managers in your institutions for national contact points. If you hear about researchers complaining or just telling you that they have problems with repositories or getting information in open air, try with them to see do they have a repository that they can use, and if not, that they can go to Zenodo. So their information is available for everyone too. This means when the information is in open air for project coordinators, we can help with reporting. There is a connection with Cordis. You can have nice reports about your publications. You can generate publication lists, and we'll talk about that a bit later. Pablo will do that. There is an FP7 post-grant open access pilot. That is a pilot on the APC's article processing charges after the end of a project. For example, this is an image of the publication list, but the tools will be explained by Pedro later on. How can we help researchers? Through the harvest into open air, they get more visibility, not only visibility of their own work, but the connection into that whole realm of research output, into that project, into the connection with data and enriched data makes that your work is more visible and even better findable, but also create a nice context of your research and your research project. And then, as I said, you can link your research results. The tools will be shown later. And then for funders, there are a few funders in the room or people having good connections with funders. our own Belgian funders still want to convince them, so it would be nice if we could have FWO or FNRS publications connected with publication information in open air, so that we can monitor, for example, how many of these publications, the percentage is really open access and which is not. And nice statistics, we always like nice statistics. There are already other funders doing this, for example, in Portugal. In Portugal, they use the system already, so that's already for 3 years or something. And also ERC is using the system to follow up. Okay, so we have project lists and things like that. Monitoring open access policies. And ultimately what we want to do is give access to the full text and to data related to it and other related information so that we have a rich EC funded research portal or other European funded nationally funded projects connected to all this information in the portal. Now this is a quick overview of what Open Air can do for you in for the Open Access mandate of the European Commission, and now Pablo will show you some tools that you can. Pedro will show you some tools that you can actually use.